Hi guys, it's me. How are all of you? Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're well. So today I thought of filming, not a haul as you can see, but a makeup related video. I thought it would be nice to film me putting on some new makeup, and it's all makeup from Dior. So basically, I'm sure you all know this, but Dior recently launched a new line of makeup, because it's not a collection of Dior, it's like a separate line, which is called Dior Backstage, and I fell in love with it. I have to admit, I fell in love with the packaging. It's all about, you know, the whole backstage vibe, so makeup artist, professional, backstage runway kind of thing, and really, really interesting, really, really nice. And I thought of getting my hands on a few items. The first item I got is actually the foundation. And this is my second purchase of this foundation because the first time I got it, the color was off. I mean, it was way too dark for me. Buying foundation online is not the easiest thing. And I know that. So I got it wrong the first time, but I got it right the second time. This is my color. It is, I think it's 2W. The first time I bought it, I got it in 4W, so it was really, really dark. I mean, I wish I was that dark, but I'm not. And just for the record, I'm a MAC NC25-ish, so this is actually a pretty good MAC match. And then I also got these two palettes. It is the eyeshadow palette in Warm Neutrals, and then the Cheek palette in 001 Universal. This is basically a highlighter palette. We are gonna play with these two as well. And then I also got these three items from Dior. They're not Dior Backstage, but just regular Dior, but they're new to me. And I thought, you know what? Let's just do a full face of makeup using just Dior and see what the verdict is. I got the Dior Addict Lip Lacquer. And I have to say, I got this color just for the name. It's called J'adore. Obviously, I had to have it. And it's this beautiful, beautiful red. And y'all know that I am all about the red, so I had to have it. Then I got the Dior Show Waterproof Liquid Liner. And Dior recently launched, I want to say about a month or a couple of months ago, a collection of eyeliners, colorful eyeliners. But I'm not too into colorful eyeliners, I have to say. So I got the regular black, and this is actually matte black, so I'm all in for that. And I like the fact that it's waterproof. So we'll be trying this one as well. And then last but not least, I've been wanting to get this item for a long time because everybody has it on YouTube. Everybody raves about it. And it's the Mascara Squeezable Volume Oversize. It's basically the pump and volume mascara. Ooh, excited to use this one. Et voila. This is what it looks like. So yes, we'll be trying this as well. And I already applied my primer, which is the CoverFX Anti-Aging Primer. Love this stuff. Right, so I don't know about you, but usually when I apply foundation, I use the Beauty Blender. And I'm a Beauty Blender girl. I've been using it for years, which means that I haven't used a brush to apply my foundation for years. So with this foundation, because it is a face and body foundation, I'm thinking it's very, very watery, and so it's pretty much water-based. And using a sponge means that the majority of the product will be absorbed by the sponge and you will get zero coverage. So this gives you a very natural coverage, but at least if you want that natural coverage, you have to use a brush. Otherwise, as I said, no coverage at all. Right, so that is one layer of foundation applied. As you can see, I mean, I'm not sure if there's much difference between now and how I looked before. But let's just say that it evened out my skin. You can definitely see, I mean, some of my flaws, like some of the hyperpigmentation, or, you know, scars, like old pimple scars. So, I mean, you can see it's not a full coverage foundation, and it's not meant to be. It doesn't promise you full coverage. So, yeah, for what it is, I like it anyway because it really does not sit on your skin at all. I mean, this looks like my natural skin. And actually, I wish I had this skin naturally because, I mean, It looks nice. Yes, you can see my flaws, but it looks nice. So, yeah. I can put another layer if I wanted to, but when it comes to foundation, like all foundations in general, I don't like to apply more layers because then I start to feel the foundation on my skin and I don't like that effect. So, yeah. We'll just keep it with one layer and then we can go on with concealer. I don't have a Dior concealer, or at least there's nothing I wanted to try concealer-wise from Dior, so we're gonna use whatever I have. I decided using the Maybelline Instant Anti-Age, this concealer. You've seen it everywhere. And I have to say, another reason why I decided to use this one is that because the foundation is so sheer, with the concealer, I can, you know, maybe add a little bit of coverage where I feel I need it. So the typical areas under your eyes, on your T-zone, just, you know, give a little bit of light. There you go. And just go out of the house like that. So yeah, there we have it, foundation and concealer on. I have to say, adding the concealer definitely helps a bit more coverage-wise, because at least, you know, whatever you want to cover, you can cover, and you still get that natural effect, because basically the foundation wasn't too heavy anyway. So yeah, this is the base, and I like it. Right, so now we can start with the eyes. So basically, this is what the eyeshadow palette looks like. This is the primer, which I've been using, not crazy about it, basically because when you use the eyeshadows, some of the dust goes on the primer, so I'm not sure how helpful that is. Anyway, we have a row of mattes, shimmers, and then a matte and shimmer up on the first row with the primer. So yeah, it's very versatile. I went for the warm neutral palette because these are the colors that I prefer. The other palette has colors that are more on the purple side of the spectrum. I prefer these ones, but they're both beautiful. And yeah, so let's get started. Not crazy about the primer, as I said, because it does get dirty, but it's handy that you have it in the palette, you know what I mean? So I'm going to use the first shimmer color, which is the lightest one. And then once that is done, we're going to go with the crease. And for the crease, I'm going to apply the second color on the matte row. So that's that. And then with the same brush, I'm going to go with the darkest matte color, just on the outer V to tie the whole look together, to tie the three colors together. So yeah, for the upper lid, that is what I do, and I will stop there. And now we can go on with eyeliner. Thanks God, I am an eyeliner girl for life. Never a day without eyeliner. So let's give this eyeliner a try. It is, as I said, the Dior Show On Stage Liner Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner, and the color is matte black. Very excited to try this because back in the day, I was a huge fan of the Makeup Forever Ink Liner, the matte one, super matte, super black, but that bad boy was not waterproof. In fact, that eyeliner would bleed like crazy, and it would drive me crazy because I love that product so much, but by midday I would have huge panda eyes because it would just bleed. So this one is waterproof, so I have very high hopes and high expectations. Guys, this eyeliner is good, okay? I am very, very, very impressed, okay? Very, very impressed. I like it. It's good. We will see if it's really waterproof, so if it doesn't bleed throughout the day. I hope not. But so far, so good. As I said, the application is very, very easy. It is black, super, super black. And yeah, I have to say, pretty mad actually. The Makeup Forever one was more matte, but this one, I mean, if it doesn't bleed, I will be very, very happy. And this might be one of my favorites if it performs well. So yeah, you can tell I'm pretty enthusiastic about it so far. Now with the lower waterline, I don't have anything from Dior because honestly, there wasn't really anything that tickled my fancy. So I'm gonna go with my trusty Marc Jacobs gel eyeliner, which is my trusty eyeliner for my waterline. This stuff does not budge. Et voila! Yes, now I finally feel like myself again. Until I don't put eyeliner, I'm telling you, I feel naked, like really, really naked. So yeah, that's for the eyes. Oh no, wait. What am I talking about? We still have the mascara. So, the Pump & Volume Mascara. We will see if it's worth the hype, if I manage to open it. Okay, so that is the mascara applied. I like it. I like it a lot. It is, it's not a clumpy mascara, so you don't have, you know, chunks of mascara on your eyelashes, which is good. It's supposed to be a volumizing mascara, but for me, I don't know. Okay, my lashes are a bit, you know, all over the place. They are short, they are straight, they are very difficult to work with. But for me, this mascara is more of a lengthening mascara more than instead of volumizing. But I like it. I like it a lot. It definitely gives me a lot of definition. And it's good. Hope you can see. Not bad. Not bad. So yes, very, very positively impressed with these products from Dior. And now we are going to powder a little bit. Not that I need powder, to be honest with you, because this foundation, it's not matte, but it's not dewy at the same time. I can go without powdering, obviously, honestly. But because I applied concealer, and I feel that if I don't powder, the products that I put on my cheek later on will not blend properly. They will be, you know, very hard to blend, so I will powder anyway. And for that, I'm going to use my trusty CoverFX Perfect Setting Powder. I already have a backup of this. That's how much I love it. And really, not too much. And then before moving on to the cheeks, we're gonna use something for my eyebrows, which is not from Dior, because also from in the eyebrows department, there was really nothing I wanted to try from Dior. There was actually the Universal pencil that I wanted to try, but my color was, I think it was out of stock when I placed the order. And by the way, when I placed the order, I had the 20% discount from Sephora. So yeah, that definitely was good. Anyway, my trusty Anastasia Brow Wiz. Oh, and thanks God, finally on the Italian Sephora, we have Anastasia. Yes. Anastasia Brow Wiz is my favorite product for my eyebrows. So yeah. I would like to get the Modern Renaissance palette from Anastasia. Everybody raves about that product, so we'll see. So now we can play with the cheek palette over here. Actually, this is not a cheek palette. This is a highlighting palette, or at least this is how it's been described from Dior. And it's true. These are four highlighters, basically. Hope you can see the colors and the shimmer in the palette. So yeah, honestly, I would have preferred if this was actually a cheek palette. That's why I tend to call it cheek palette. But because I would have liked if the bronzer was matte. Because if the bronzer was matte, this could have been a very, very great and fantastic cheek palette. But it's not. It's a shimmer. So using, and I've been using this as my bronzer, and using a shimmer bronzer, we all know that it is a no-no. Nevertheless, I don't know what it is, but when you apply it on your cheeks, the shimmer does not show a lot. You know what I mean? At least this color, or at least the way I apply it. And that's a good thing because in the morning, I just love the idea of having this for my cheeks, applying everything and I'm done. Definitely, if you are not a shimmer girl, you don't like highlighter, you don't like being a disco ball at 7 o'clock in the morning, then this is not for you. But I'm all about the glow. So this is right up my alley. Still, I would have preferred if the bronzer was matte, but nevertheless, I'm gonna use it. I'm gonna show you how it looks, and maybe you tell me if it's good or not. I'm gonna use an angle brush for the bronzer, which again, it's not a bronzer, it's a blush. Actually, this color is described by Dior as a blush, but I call it bronzer. So yeah, there definitely is shimmer, but not so much when it comes to the darker color, the bronzer. And then we go with the blush. And I love blushes that are already shimmery and blingy because I feel it's a two-in-one. You don't really need to add highlighter afterwards. Fake smile. So yeah. That's been my jam for the past week. A lot of going on the cheeks, as you can see. But I've been loving it. Really, really loving it. And then, on the inner corners of my eyes, I'm going to use the white. Just because we have it, so might as well use it. Whoa. Love it, love it. And then last but not least, we are gonna use the Jadier. If I manage to open it. Okay guys, so this is my full face of makeup using mainly Dior, because there were a few products that were not Dior, but we can say a good 80% of the makeup was Dior. And final verdict, I love it. I mean, it's good, okay? Let's just go one by one and do a recap. The foundation is a natural finish foundation, okay? It's not matte, it's not luminous. It's an in-between. The coverage is, people say it's medium. I wanna say it's slightly under medium. It's not really medium, it evens out your skin. You have to do a little bit of concealer work, a little extra concealer work if you really want to cover whatever you want to cover, which is what I do. But the end result is really, really nice. I like it. Is this my holy grail favorite foundation? No, absolutely not. I will always be a faithful Huda Beauty faux filter foundation girl. I love that stuff. That is my OG, okay? We cannot even compare. But I'm glad I tried it because on those days in which I want to put on something but not be, wow, here I am kind of a thing, this is definitely a good option. So I'm glad I tried it. For the eyeshadow palette, also I'm very, very happy I got it. I like the size of it. I like that it has a clear cover so you can see the colors. It's compact. I use it on a day-to-day basis. The colors are very easy to work with. I obviously, for this tutorial, I went a little bit overboard, but when I go to work, I usually just apply one lid color, max two, and I'm ready to go. I mean, it's very easy. The colors are very, very easy to work with. They blend beautifully and they stay on the whole day. So that is good. It's also very good that you have a primer. So, you know, it's all here. You don't have, you know, to go and grab and look for things in your makeup stash. It's all here. So that's something I really, really like. Then the cheek palette is also another one of my favorites. I love it. It is all in your face, which is my jam. And I love it. I'm all for the bling girl. That's just me. So, I mean, obviously, I'm gonna love it. And then for the other products that are not Dior Backstage, just regular Dior, love, love, love. I love the eyeliner so, so much. So easy to apply. The mascara is great. The lip product, I mean, I'm all about the reds. So I was obviously gonna love it. and I knew it from the beginning. So yes, very happy I decided to add these three products as well. So yeah, the Dior Brack Stage is a great line, makeup line. These three products from Dior are also fantastic. So I have to say, trying these new products, trying everything from Dior was actually good. It was a success. I mean, there's nothing I do not like. Okay, let's just put it that way. I love everything. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. It's something different. I've been loving makeup recently. I'm very prone to makeup ruts. I wear the same thing every single day. But recently, I've been on the Sephora website more than usual because, you know, there are some new things that are really intriguing me and that I'm loving, so I want to try. I want to try everything. So, yeah, that's all. Definitely stay tuned because after this, there is a haul coming up. So, I know that is what we love and a very, very exciting purchase. Let me just tell you, it's going to be the first handbag of 2018. I can't believe that we are basically in July because today is the last day of June. And I haven't bought a handbag this year yet. So, that's it, guys. Stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching. And until my next video, bye-bye.